Hello everyone, how are you all? I hope you are liking my video. So today I am going to show you the linking, internal and external linking within your HTML web page. First one is the external linking, which helps you to link your page with a different web page. For this you have to give a particular path for creating a link. The link can be easily created with the help of a tag, which is called as the anchor tag. It allows you to create a link with a different web page. It has two attributes within external linking. First one is href, which is hypertext reference, wherein you have to write the full location of the page or the file with which you want to create the link. And second one is the target attribute, which helps you or which allows you to decide that the page with which you are creating a link that you want to open on the same tab or a different tab. If the value of the target will be underscore blank, then it is going to open the page in a different tab, and if the value will be underscore top, then it will be open on the same web page. So it will overlap the page, and then the linked website or linked the page will be, or linked file will be open there. Let's begin with our video and see how we can create the external link. So I have written the HTML and head. I'm going to write the title, external linking. So for external linking, we have two attributes with us, href and target. Going to open the body tag. Now I'll use the anchor tag. A is the tag which is used for doing the, or you can say, linking to another page. It has the attribute href, hypertext reference, in which I'm going to give the name of the file which is there on the desktop. Any file name you can give here. So nestedlist.html, and then whatever text you want to write on which you want to create a link, you have to write this text. So let's say I have written here, click here, close the anchor tag, close the body tag, and then HTML tag. Go and save the file. So saving the file to the desktop only, and let's say I've saved. Now I'm going to open it. So once you open it, you will see a click here link over there. Let me increase the size so that you can view it in a better way. See, it is now written click here. There is a external linking name on the title bar, which we have given under the title tag, and here I have written click here. So once you click here, the nestedlist.html file will be, web page will be open in front of you. Now what is target attribute? As I have not given any target means if you want it to be open in a separate web page, if you want the link to be open in a separate web page, you can define the target here underscore blank. And if you want to open it under the same web page, then you have to define underscore top. So it will open the linked page on the same window. So see, as I have written target blank, so a separate window is open here, and external linking window is here only, and the linked window is open in a different tab. And if you want it to be open or overlapped on the same window, you have to write it target top. Save the file. Now let me close this so that you can see the changes. See, it is open, overlapped. By default it will be open on the same tab, but if you want it to be open on a different tab, you can define the target as blank. I hope you have understood now that how you can do a external linking, or how you can link any kind of file to your web page or any text written over there. Now, let us begin with the internal linking.
Now, we will see the internal linking. What is internal linking? It will help you to create a link within the web page. It means inside the same web page, you can create a link which can be done by the relative or absolute path. Path means the location. So in this, what we have to do, we have to create a link with the two attributes, which is name and href for internal linking. In name, we have to write the assign a word or a name which will refer to the section of your page, and then in href we have to assign that name or write that name preceded by the hash symbol, which will create a which will make that word a particular keyword, or you can say it will create a link to that word and it will search that word in a particular web page. And this is how you can create a linking within the web page.
So let us now see the internal linking, how it works. So I am again writing the same thing. In the title I will write internal linking, close the title tag, close the head tag, and as we know that internal linking basically creates a link within the web page, and it has two attributes which work together. One is href, which we have used with the anchor tag during external linking also, and one is the name attribute. So what the name attribute when I write use the name attribute along with the anchor tag, the name attribute gives the name to the particular text which you define here. And when I will use the same name with the hypertext reference, then it will become a kind of a, you can say, a keyword or a link. It will create a link and the browser will search for that particular word when you will click on the link there. So let us see how it works. So now suppose I am defining here the name as HTML. And then I am closing the anchor tag, and let's write a particular paragraph so that we can search for a particular word HTML. I am going to write few text or few sentences here, and when I will cover up my web page and when I will create a link to the HTML, it will navigate through the web page with the help of this internal linking. How it works, see, I have started a paragraph now. Suppose I have written HTML is very easy to learn. Let's give a br tag here. It is not case sensitive language. HTML is derived from HTML. HTML is called as the ancestor of HTML, and it has predefined tags. I'm going to show you in my way how I have understood this internal linking. I am going to close this paragraph. And I'm going to copy this paragraph again, and I will again paste it here so that my whole web page got covered. And now when my web page be covered, I'm going to write open here an anchor tag with the hypertext reference attribute, and I am going to write the same keyword which I have defined on the top for creating a link. And the browser will now going search the HTML word when I will click on this go to top button or go to top link. So what I have done, I have defined the anchor tag, hypertext reference, the HTML keyword, the name which I have already defined within the this name attribute of anchor tag. And for creating a link, I have to precede this name by the hash symbol. So I have to add the hash symbol before the starting of the name, and Then I have written a word on which I want to create a link. So close the body tag, close the HTML tag. Now save this as internallinking.html and I'm going to execute this file. Now see, my whole web page is containing the text, but when I click on go to top, right now you are not able to judge or see that how the text is searched. So you might have found these kind of links, internal linking, within many websites. So to making it more clear, what I am going to do, I'm going to copy the text 2-3 times more and we'll save it, refresh it. Let me save it once more. Refresh it. Now see, this has been written here. Now I came downstairs after reading the website or web page. Now I have seen here go to top link. When I will click here go to top, it will search for the HTML keyword which is written within the go to top link, and I will be there on the top. You can write any name which you want. Suppose I want to go to if you want to go to top, obviously you have to write the name from the top of the line, and this is how you can create an internal linking. I hope you have understood this. This is my way of understanding the internal linking work. First we have to define the name on which we want to create a linking, and then we have to, for making it as a keyword or creating a link, we have to add a hash symbol and then the name which we have defined, and then write the name on which you want to create a link. So this is how it will go to the top. When it will you will click on go to top, it is going to search the HTML word, and the first time it will found the HTML word, the cursor will go there only. You can try it with the middle of the sentences also. Okay, so I hope you have understood this. You may give the name of any particular file as well, if you want any particular file to be created or linked here. So let me see here. See, if you write the name of any particular file, like hypertext reference nestedlist.html is the file, and I have written the keyword here. So if you click on go to top, it is going to, firstly the text is linked with the file, so the file will be searched first and the file will be opened in front of you. I will show you once more. Go to top, it will go to the file first of all, and if you want the word to be searched, you have to remove this name and save it. And if you want to create an internal linking within the file only, within the particular web page only, then there is no need of writing the file name. So this is how it works. I hope you have understood the internal linking. So let us now see how to create a mail to link, or you can say that how you can send the email link on your web page. If you want someone to send you an email through your HTML web page, then there is a mail to you can say the add a value which can be used with href and anchor tag, which helps you to create a mail to link. So what we are going to write, I have already written the head tag, title, in title I have written mail to, and I have started the body tag. So what I will do, I will write anchor tag and then hypertext reference equal to, you have to give a double quote. This is a syntax, basically you have to write like this only, mail to, and then the mail address on which you want the mail to be sent. So I am writing zone courier ipl2020@gmail.com. If you want to give a subject, then write a question mark and then write the subject, and with the subject you can write here, suppose feedback, and subject will be written in a single quote, and then this double quote which I have started before the mail to, that will be closed, and then write the word on which you want to create this link. So I'm going to write that share your feedback and close the anchor tag. Now save the file. I'm going to save it as the name mail2.html. Now execute it. Let's see what happens. Now see, there is a link created with share your feedback name, and when I will click on this, Outlook window will be open where the subject is already written, feedback, and my mail address is already present. So if someone wants me to send the mail, he or she can write anything and just click on the send. So this is how you can create a mail link onto your web page.
My video, subscribe to my channel, press the bell icon and share it. I'll be back again with the next video very soon. Till then, stay safe, stay home. Thank you.